I'm Chris Thacker, and this is the Curiosity Show from the Natural History Museum of Los Angeles County. Los Angeles is a hybrid environment where our city is laid on top of and interacts with the natural landscape. And it turns out that that landscape is full of birds. We've got year-round natives, we've got migratory visitors, and we've got a whole host of introduced species. We're exploring LA's birds today and learning how the natives and the newcomers get along. I'm here in Ornithology with Kimball Garrett, and Kimball is our collections manager in Ornithology. How are you doing, Kimball?
I'm wonderful, thank you. How are you, Chris?
I'm good. Thanks for talking birds with us today.
Sure.
There's an unusual lot of birds here in LA. Why is that?
Well, we do have the most bird species recorded in our county of any county in the entire United States, roughly 524, something like that at last count. It's the diversity of habitats is basically it. We go from an ocean to a 10,000 foot mountain range, a desert.
So we have natives that live here in the city, in the natural areas and in the city, and then we have migrants that come through. And then what about introduced birds? Do we have an unusually high amount of introduced birds?
Los Angeles is swimming in, well, I shouldn't say that to a fish person.
Yeah.
Los Angeles is flying in introduced birds.
Why is it good for introduced birds as well?
Well, there's a thriving pet trade here, and most of these originate from the pet trade. The other reason is we have planted what's an incredibly varied environment for birds around the world. We've imported tropical and subtropical trees and shrubs. We import the water to water them, and we provide food and nest sites for birds of really diverse ecologies.
Oh, okay. So the introduced birds oftentimes are living on the introduced plants.
Absolutely. In fact, in most cases, they're not really getting into our natural habitats at all.
Okay, this brings up a really interesting distinction when we study urban nature and we talk about native species that are here naturally, and then introduced species are those that were brought by humans. But there's a distinction between an introduced species and an invasive species, where an invasive species is one that's actually spreading and causing problems. So these birds then would be introduced but not invasive. Is that right?
By and large, that's true. We think of invasive as introduced species which have either ecological impacts on native species or economic impacts on things like crops.
And we have birds that do great in urban environments, and some of them are crazy. And we have the ones that I want to talk to you about are the introduced parrots. We have flocks of introduced parrots in Los Angeles. And when I first moved here, I was in a meeting and I was looking out the window. I'd been here maybe a week. And all of a sudden, this flock of parrots lifts out of one of the trees right there in the parking lot, kicking up this huge racket.
They do that.
And flies right by the window. I thought I was in Ecuador. And we have
some specimens. Yeah, we've been trying to develop the collections of these founding populations of many of these introduced species.
Ooh, escape from the pet trade. Let's go have a look.
So here's a tray of red-crowned parrots.
Okay.
This is the most abundant naturalized parrot in the Los Angeles area. There are certainly thousands of them. We don't know exactly how many.
There's thousands of them right here. These are huge.
Well, they're good-sized birds. A little smaller than a crow, but good size. They're native to northeastern Mexico, but they're brought here for the pet trade, and they've just been incredibly successful.
And now, are these noisy like the other ones?
They'll squawk. Phenomenally noisy. Parrots are social birds, and social creatures
communicate
a lot. In the case of parrots, that means screaming and screeching. And another one that we see right here at the Natural History Museum practically every day is called the yellow chevroned parakeet.
Oh, these must have been the ones I saw.
These are the common ones here. So they get that name from this little yellow marker patch on the wings. Otherwise, they're small, slender, with a pointy tail. And they're loud too, but they're not as horribly loud and screechy as the Amazon parrots.
And I know there's one more big green common introduced parrot. What is it? What have we got here?
Yeah, one, actually several more, but this is one of our most numerous. This is called the mitred parakeet.
Okay.
So it's another group from South America in this case that have sort of long pointed tails. Again, mostly green with some yellow adornments on them. Also very noisy. They eat a huge variety of seeds, fruits, nectar, and again, they like the red-crowned parrots and the yellow chevron parakeets. They find what they need here and thrive. And that's the thing about these non-native species is once they're here and you know they're here and there's lots of them, it's pretty much too late to do much about it, especially things like birds and a lot of aquatic creatures. There may be some, you know, if we had giraffes invading here, we could probably dispatch them pretty easily.
Fantastic. Kimball, thank you so much.
This is
a great story.
Sure.